Morning, students. Yesterday we have started with the chapter from the diary of Anne Frank. As I told you about the background of Anne Frank, that how she was living in a hiding in an annex, and ultimately, finally, the family was betrayed by a friend, and they have been taken to the concentration camps where Anne Frank died of typhus fever. And after her death, at the age of 13 or 14 years, when she started her writing, and after her death, the diary, it was recovered by her father, and ultimately it was suggested to him that it should be printed in the form of a book. And this was really a great example, and moreover, it stood the testimony of times, and it stood as an example of the life of the people during World War II, when the German has overtaken the Nazis. So ultimately, it was really very difficult time. This story of Anne Frank, it is an example not to leave hope at any time and be always the winner. She, although living in a concentration camp and moreover in a hiding, she has never lost hope. She has portrayed each and every incident of her life in the form of diary entries in the actual novel, that is the Diary of a Young Girl. And ultimately, this is just an excerpt which has been taken in your books in the form of this chapter from the Diary of Anne Frank. So yesterday we have studied that how she has started writing about it, that she has started writing about it. Earlier she thought that why people record only the main incidents or the important things in the diary. But later on, she thought that as paper has more patience than people. Why? Because one day she was feeling quite depressed and she did not know whether to stay in or to go out of the house. So she decided to write down her depressed feelings in the form of the words, and she has started writing diary. And later on she has told that it is not like that she does not have a loving family. Of course, there is a loving father, loving mother, and a loving sister. She has many friends also, but she said that she did not confide in any of the friends. So she wanted to she never disclosed her feelings to any of her friends, and maybe she thought that it may be a sort of weakness on her part only. And later on, she thought that in this diary, she would write down her all the important feelings and all the important things in this diary. And finally, she has also named this diary as Kitty. So till here we have studied. So now I'm going to share with you the chapter from where we have to start. Now it is going to be displayed onto your screens. So we have studied. We have studied till here. Question answers we will do afterwards. Okay, so let us start from the next page. So now it is going to be displayed onto your books. So let us start. Yes. Since no one would understand a word of my stories to Kitty, if I were to plunge right in, I would better provide a brief sketch of my life, much as I dislike doing so. So she said that if I would only proceed towards writing my diary, if anybody would read my diary, no one would be able to come to know who am I and why I was writing a diary. So finally, she thought that she should actually rather provide a brief sketch of her life, who she and why she is writing a diary. She told that she did not like giving this kind of description, but she has to. So she said that my father, the most adorable father I have ever seen, he didn't marry my mother until he was 36 and she was 25. So she has given the background of her father as well as mother, that her father was quite loving one, adorable one. And when he was 36 years of age, he has married her mother, who was only 25 at that time. My sister Margot. So what was the name of the sister? Margot. My sister Margot was born in Frankfurt in Germany in 1926. This line is very well clear. And I was born on June 1929. So when was Anne Frank was born? She was born on June 12, 1929. I lived in Frankfurt until I was 4. So where she lived? She lived in Frankfurt till she was 4 years of age. My father immigrated to Holland in 1933. She is giving just a brief life sketch of father and mother, that how he started his journey, and later on he has immigrated to Holland in 1933. My mother, Edith Hollander Frank. So underline the name of the mother, that is Edith Hollander Frank. Underline in your books. Edith Hollander Frank, and she went with him to Holland in September. It means that when her father has shifted to Holland, her mother has not gone along with him. Later on, she has shifted there. And while Margot and I were sent to Ashen to live with our grandmother. So the children were left behind, both the girls. And later on, after some time, they have gone to Holland. Margot went to Holland in December and I followed in February, when I was plunked down on the table as a birthday present for Margot. It means Margot was not knowing that she is going to be born, and ultimately when she has gone there as a birthday present, she was going to be presented to her. I started right away at Montessori Nursery School. So now she has come to her schooling. So what she said, that she started her school at Montessori Nursery School. I stayed there until I was 6, at which time I started in the first term. In the 6th form, my teacher was Mrs. Cupress, the headmistress. At the end of the year, we were both in tears as we said a heartbreaking farewell. So she said, till 6th form, she has good relations with the teachers and the headmistress at 6th, Mrs. Cupress. When she's going to leave the school in class 6, they both had tears in their eyes. It means this is the kind of attachment. It means she is always attached with her teachers since her childhood. It means she respects her teachers a lot. In the summer of 1941, grandma fell ill and had to have an operation. So my birthday passed with little celebration. So in 1941, she told, in 1942, she started writing diaries. So she is not talking about much, you can say, old incident. She is talking about only 1 or 2 years back, and in the starting only she has given only explanation of the family. So what she said, in summer 1941, what happened, her grandmother, she had fallen ill, so she has to undergo an operation. But what has happened, as she has to undergo an operation, that ultimately her birthday was in her birthday was in 1941. And ultimately what has happened? She said that her birthday, it passed without with little celebration. It means it was not celebrated much. Her grandma died in January 1942. Yes. So the grandmother, she did not survive because she was operated, and because of weak health, she passed away. And no one knows how often I think of her and still love her. It means that she's greatly in love with her grandmother, and she says that no one knows how often I remember and how much I love her. It means still she misses her grandmother, and ultimately she loves her a lot. So this also shows that Anne Frank is an emotional child. She is deeply in love with her teachers and her other family relations. She has mentioned about her father also. An adorable father. She has also mentioned on the previous page, when she is giving an introduction, that she does not have any friends to confide in. But there she mentioned, this doesn't mean that she doesn't have a loving family. She of course has a loving family. Okay, so it means that she's quite an emotional girl, sensitive as well as loving towards everyone. Now, this birth, I think of her and still love her. This birthday celebration in 1942 was intended to make up for the other, and grandma's candle was lit along with the rest. So when her birthday comes in 1942, it was going It was intended to make up for the other. It means now what she has done, she has lit a candle in front of the portrait or the photograph of her mother and while remembering her. So this shows her close attachment with the grandmother. So here the question can be asked, how Anne Frank was attached to her grandmother. Okay, so you can write down here that in 1941, when her grandma fell ill and had to undergo an operation, and her birthday, she did not celebrate her birthday, or it passed on without celebration, or it was held with little celebration. And later on, when her grandma died in 1942, she did not celebrate her birthday, but she lit a candle in front of the photograph of her grandmother, remembering her and paying a tribute to her. Now, the four of us are still doing well. And that brings me to the present day, 20 June 1942. So she has mentioned only that chunks of her life that was important to her. She has mentioned about her father, mother, sister, and moreover now grandmother, with whom she was deeply in love with. Okay, so what she has said, now four of us means that mother, father, her sister Margot, and she said we were doing well, and now I have come to this time, that is 20 June 1942, and this is my time to write a diary. Okay, so let us go to the next page. So this is the diary entry. See at the top right hand corner, Saturday 20 June 1942. I told you that the actual book, actual now what it is entirely in the form of diary entries. Only diary entries are mentioned there. And ultimately, because of these diary entries, we have to get a sketch of her life. And of course, that was not a sketch of her life only. It was the sketch of a life of the persons who were living in hiding, okay, during World War II. So this is the reason why it is a great example of English literature. So now coming up here to the next page. So this is the diary entry that has been mentioned. So, dearest Kitty, this way she is starting. Who is Kitty here? Kitty is her diary in which she is writing her experiences and the parts of her life. Our entire class is quaking in its boots. Quaking in its boots means they were quite nervous. They were quite fearful. They were afraid. When students used to be afraid, it is the only time when results have to be announced or tests have to be conducted. So she said, we were quaking in its boots. Now let us see what is the reason of their nervousness. The reason, of course, is the forthcoming meeting in which the teachers decide who will move up to the next form and who will be kept back. It means that it's the result time. So she said that we were all trembling with fear. Why? Because it is the time when the teachers, they are going to discuss and formulate their opinion and formulate their results about which student will move to the next form and who will stay behind. And it is on the basis of all the basis of the performance in all the subjects. So half the class is making bets. Jian and I laugh ourselves silly at the two boys behind us. Jian means name of the friend, she said, and I was laughing with my friend that the two boys sitting behind, they won't pass. So CN and Jack, who have staked their entire holiday savings on their bet, from morning to night, it's you're going to pass. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Even G's pleading glances. Pleading means requesting, glances mean looks. And my angry outburst can't calm them down. She said that throughout the day, we all were discussing, yes, you will pass, I will pass, he will not pass. So in this manner, this entire discussion, it went on throughout the day. Now, after that, what she said that even sometimes I used to laugh in between my angry outburst. Sometimes I got angry also in order to calm down the situation, but this couldn't help you help me out. Pusheen has entered quite late. Now, if you ask me, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back, but teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on the earth. She said, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back. Means there are number of presumptions among them that half quarter means 1/4 of the class it will be kept back. Why it should be kept back? Because they were not performing well on the basis of their discipline problems, also on the basis of their performance in the various subjects. But she said, but teachers are most unpredictable creatures on earth. Why she said so? Because it is not possible for them to predict that what decision will be made by the teachers. So I'm not so worried about my girlfriends and myself. We will make it. The only subject I'm not sure about is maths. Yes. She said in all the subjects, in rest of the subjects, I was doing quite well. She said I was not at all worried about my performance in rest of the subjects. But actually, what I was worried of was my subject, that is mathematics. Anyway, all we can do is wait. So nothing else can be done. She said there is no other option except to wait, and we have to wait. Until then, we kept telling each other not to lose heart, and we were just consoling each other, don't lose heart, don't lose heart, we will make up, we will pass on. Now, I get along pretty well with all my teachers. There are 9 of them, 7 men and 2 women. Mr. Keezing, the only foggy means unpredictable, old-fashioned man, okay, who doesn't go with the changing trends. So she said I was not worried about my friends. With all my teachers, I was doing quite well. There are actually 9 teachers, 7 are men and 2 women. But she was worried about Mr. Keezing. She has called Miss. She does not. It means that she does not have good relations with Mr. Keezing. This is the reason why she has called Mr. Keezing as old foggy. Who teaches us math? So what he teaches them? Mathematics. She was annoyed with me for ages because I talked so much. So what is the reason of having, you can say, relationship full of friction with Mr. Keezing? And why relationship of Anne is filled of friction, is filled with friction with that of Mr. Keezing? It is because of the reason that she talks a lot in the class. Naturally, when you talk a lot, you will disturb the class, you will grab the attention of the teacher, but in a negative way. So naturally, so this has happened with her. As she was talking a lot, and she was always being pointed out by the teacher, and this is the reason why she was being disliked by Mr. Keezing. After several warnings, he assigned me extra homework, an essay on the subject, a chatterbox. A chatterbox? What can you write about that? I would worry about that later. I jotted down the title of in my notebook, tucked it in my bag, and tried to keep quiet. So when she said that when I was talking in the class, Mr. Keezing, he has assigned me an homework to write an essay on chatterbox. Okay, so what is a chatterbox? Means the person who talks a lot, we used to call it as chatterbox. So now she said, what can one write on chatterbox? What can be written in this chatterbox? But finally she said, what I did, I noted down the topic in my notebook, put down the notebook into my bag, and finally I tried to be quiet, to remain quiet in the class. So naturally, see her sincerity, she's going to write an essay on chatterbox. So what happened? That evening after I had finished the rest of my homework, the note about the essay caught my eye. She says, when she went home and in the evening, she has completed the rest of her work. And finally, what she thought, now her sight caught the attention of the point that she has noted in her notebook, that she has to write an essay on chatterbox. I began thinking about the subject while chewing the tip of my fountain pen. So naturally, she was chewing. She was, you can say, chewing and sucking the tip of her fountain pen because she was thinking of the ideas that what can be written in this essay that is called as chatterbox. Anyone could ramble on and leave big spaces between the words. Ramble on means talk idly about, could not relate it to the context. She said, if this chatterbox, it could be given to anyone, anyone could ramble on upon the topic and would leave big spaces in between in order to fill the space. But she said, but the trick was to come up with convincing arguments to prove the necessity of talking. But she thought that what she should write down in her essay, that she should write down in her essay that what is the reason of talking, why she is talking, and ultimately she should present some arguments in her essay. I thought and thought, and suddenly I had an idea. I wrote the 3 pages Mr. Keesing had assigned me and was satisfied. I argued that talking is a student's trait. Trait means character, and that I would do my best to keep it under control. So what she has written, she said, in the response to this homework given to me, she has written almost 3 pages on this essay, that is, on this essay, that is Chatterbox. She has presented her all arguments in order to justify her point that what is the need of talking in the class. So what she has mentioned in her essay, she has written that talking is a student's trait. This is a character of student. A student will definitely talk in the class. But she ultimately agreed to that point also, that she should keep her this habit under control in the class. So moving on to the next page, but that I would never be able to cure myself of the habit, since my mother talked as much as I did, if not more, and that there's not much you can do about inherited traits. Inherited means the traits means characters which are being imbibed from the parents or from passed from one generation to the next generation. So she said, but that would not be able to cure myself. She said, but I try to keep it under control, but that doesn't mean that I will stop talking in the class. But actually, she has given the actual reason of her talking, that her mother, she talks a lot. And this is the reason why she has inherited this trait from her mother. Now, Mr. Keesing had a good laugh at my argument. So see the behavior of the teacher when he read that essay. He had a good laugh. He laughed a lot on her arguments. But when I proceeded to talk my way through the next lesson, he assigned me a second essay. She said, when I have proceeded, I have submitted my first essay, and again I talked in the class, then what he has done, Mr. Keesing has given her another essay to write. Second essay again. Why? Because she was talking in the class. This time it was supposed to be on an incorrigible chatterbox. Incorrigible means that cannot be corrected. Okay, so this time what essay he has given to her? He has given to her an essay because her habit of talking in the class, it was not at all improved, and she has been given an essay to be written, that is an incorrigible chatterbox. I handed it in, and Mr. Keesing had nothing to complain about for 2 whole lessons. She said, I have written it in my notebook, but for next 2 lessons, Mr. Keesing hasn't told me anything. He hasn't even pointed out me also. However, during the 3rd lesson, he had finally had enough. Anne Frank, as punishment for talking in class, write an essay entitled Quack, Quack, Quack. For 2 lessons, as Anne Frank did not talk, Mr. Keesing did not speak. But in the 3rd lecture, when she again started talking, this again irritated Mr. Keesing. And he has told Anne Frank to write an essay finally on the topic Quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. This was actually quite insulting for Anne Frank also in the class, as she has to write an essay again and again on the same topic, and the topic was also related to her speaking habit a lot. Now, let us see what she's going to write here in this case. The class roared. So everyone laughed in the class that she has again given an essay to be written for her for her talking habit. I had to laugh too. Naturally, she was also in the same boat. She also laughed, though I had nearly exhausted my ingenuity on the topic of chatterbox. Ingenuity means originality. She said, although actually I have given all the ideas, all my arguments in those first 2 essays, and now I don't have any other idea to write down. I have lost all my originality. That what should be written in this chatterbox. It was time to come up with something else, something original. So now she thought that now it's time to write something else, something other, so that must be more convincing for Mr. Keesing, my friend Sam, who's good at poetry. She offered to help me write the essay from beginning to end in verse. Verse means in poem form. So her friend Sam, who was good in writing poems, she has offered to help her to write all the essay in the form of poem. And I jumped for joy, and she was jumping with joy that now she can do her work. Mr. Keesing was trying to play a joke on me with this ridiculous subject, but I would make sure the joke was on him. So what she thought that Mr. Keesing was trying to make fun of me in the class, but now with my this poem I would definitely make fun of him. I finished my poem and it was beautiful. It was about a mother duck and a father swan with three baby ducklings who were bitten to death by the father because they quacked too much. So what she has written in the poem, that she has mentioned a story about a duck as well as a swan, both male and female, and their three ducklings. And the father duck, he has bitten all the three ducklings to death. Why? Because they were talking a lot. Luckily, Mr. Keesing took the joke the right way. He read the poem to the class, adding his own comments and to several other classes as well. So finally, but he did not take it in the form that it was insulting for him, but rather he has taken it in another way, like that he liked it very much, and with adding some comments he has shown that poem in there. He has read that poem in their class also, as well as in the other classes too. So since then I have been allowed to talk and haven't been assigned any extra homework. So what she said, since then, after that, what has happened? She said that Mr. Keesing, then finally he has understood that actually I couldn't stop talking, and finally next day onwards she was never being given any extra work for being talking in the class. And moreover, she said that he has never stopped me to talk in the class. On the contrary, Mr. Keesing's always making jokes these days. So this is how her relationship has changed with Mr. Keesing, the mathematics teacher. So finally, through this chapter, what we have come to know about the ideas or the feelings of youngsters, that children, they too need to be talked with. They too need that their feelings should be shared with. And moreover, it also shows the great relationship between the student and the teacher, that the relationship between a student and the teacher, it should be that of understanding. It should be that of reality, but not that of, you can say, a dictator as well as a subordinate. So ultimately, she has exemplified with the help of, you can say, Mr. Keesing, that what kind of life and what kind of feelings young students, they want and they, you can say, aspire for. So this is with this one chapter, we have a deep understanding of the character of Anne Frank, that what kind of girl she was. Okay, she was loving, she was filled with feelings, she was emotional too, greatly in deeply in love with her grandmother, and moreover she has developed good relationships with her teachers also, but with Mr. Keesing, whom she was afraid because she was talking a lot in the class. But later on, how the relationship it changed. So if I will ask you, who was Kitty? Kitty is the diary of Anne Frank in which she was noting down her feelings, right? And I hope that now it's all clear to you. The chapter is quite clear to you. It is, you can say, humorous also, moreover enjoyable also. You must have enjoyed it very well, and you must have learned about Anne Frank. You must have heard the name of Anne Frank too. Okay, so yes, finally many students are putting their thumbs up. Yes, finally you like. Okay, so with this we are going to end this chapter, and tomorrow we are going to start with the discussion of the question answers of this chapter.